In this video, we will talk about the different type of interventions for people with 22q11 deletion syndrome who have developed a psychotic disorder. Also, we will discuss the side effects and precautions associated with antipsychotic drugs. You have heard already that people with 22q11 deletion syndrome have an increased risk for psychosis. Approximately 30 to 40% of people with 22q11 deletion syndrome will develop a psychotic disorder at some stage during their lives. Treatment of psychosis in 22q11 deletion syndrome in general is similar as for people with psychosis in the general population. Starting an antipsychotic treatment is the first step, bearing the go slow and low in mind, particularly for people with 22q11 deletion syndrome, because they are vulnerable. In young people, there is most experience with risperidone and aripiprazole as antipsychotic treatment because these drugs have been studied very well in clinical trials with children and adolescents. In adults, however, for psychosis, there's a larger choice of antipsychotic drugs because this has been studied much more common. In general, the first choice will be a second generation antipsychotic drug, like, for example, quetiapine, olanzapine, risperidone, or aripiprazole. Haloperidol or Pimozid, which are first-generation drugs, can be used as well. The choice of drugs really depends on individual risk profiles, taking the side effects that all antipsychotics have into consideration. Clozapine, the antipsychotic drug of choice in treatment-resistant psychosis, has been used also successfully in adults with 22q11 deletion syndrome and psychosis, sometimes leading to impressive clinical improvement. It is the most effective antipsychotic drug we have. However, it also has a lot of side effects. And there are patients with 22q11 deletion syndrome who do not tolerate clozapine, unfortunately, and will have to stop taking it, despite having clinical improvements. Concomitant treatment of psychosis with an anticonvulsant like valproate or lamotrigine may stabilize the clinical picture and sometimes stabilize fluctuating mood, and at the same time prevent occurrence of convulsions. Side effects of antipsychotic treatment need special attention in 22q11 deletion syndrome because they can occur as independent somatic manifestations of 22q11 deletion syndrome in the absence of antipsychotic treatment. The side effects can be classified into 5 categories. First, movement disorders. Second, weight gain. Third, seizures. Fourth, cardiac side effects. And finally, cytopenias. The movement disorders include extrapyramidal symptoms like Parkinsonism, dystonia, and myoclonus. These are frequently reported in individuals with 22q11 deletion syndromes that are treated with antipsychotic drugs. However, they have also been reported in people who don't take antipsychotic drugs, and they could be part of Parkinson's disease. Since we know that Parkinson's disease is associated with people with 22q11 deletion syndrome, particularly in adulthood, it's very important to differentiate between side effects of antipsychotic drugs or a starting emerging Parkinson's disorder. In this case, you have to consult with a neurologist. Movement disorders have also been reported in people with 22q11 deletion syndrome taking clozapine. Then we go to seizures. Seizures have been reported after starting quetiapine, aripiprazole, risperidone, and most often in clozapine. Up to 44% of patients with 22q11 deletion syndrome taking clozapine report seizures. And in 50% of these cases, it concerns first-time seizures. Antipsychotics are known to lower the threshold for seizures. And we know that people with 22q11 deletion syndrome are already at increased risk for developing seizures. So extra caution is needed when starting antipsychotic treatment in people with 22q11 deletion syndrome. And also here, it is very important to consult a neurologist. Clozapine is the antipsychotic drug that is most commonly associated with seizures. So again, it's very important to consult with a neurologist. Weight gain has also been commonly reported in people with 22q11 deletion syndrome who use antipsychotic drugs. More specifically, it has been reported in associated with quetiapine, risperidone and clozapine use in 22q11 deletion syndrome. However, weight gain has also been reported in people with 22q11 deletion syndrome who don't take antipsychotic drugs. Particularly in adulthood, we know that weight gain is a risk. So here again, it's very important to pay special attention to lifestyle and dietary. Cardiac side effects of antipsychotic medication have been reported in single cases. For example, clozapine-induced myocarditis has been described incidentally. In addition, QT prolongation after sertraline was added to quetiapine and risperidone was observed. So awareness of interaction with other psychotic drugs is necessary, and one should always make an ECG prior to starting antipsychotic treatment. Neutropenia, leukopenia, and in rare cases, agranulocytosis have been reported, particularly with clozapine. Therefore, careful monitoring of white blood cell count and doing this already prior to starting clozapine treatment is essential. Thrombocytopenia has also been described in patients that used clozapine, risperidone, haloperidol, olanzapine, and perfenazine. However, since thrombocytopenia is commonly occurring in people with 22q11 deletion syndrome who do not take antipsychotic drugs, also here, blood sampling and determining the thrombocyte count prior to starting antipsychotic drug is necessary. Although no causality with the antipsychotic drugs can be determined, and some symptoms also occur in people with 22q11 deletion syndrome who do not take antipsychotic medication, it seems that people with 22q11 deletion syndrome are more susceptible to side effects than people who do not have 22q11 deletion syndrome. Particularly, people with 22q11 deletion syndrome taking clozapine seem more susceptible to serious side effects. When we talk about non-pharmacological interventions and management for psychosis in people with 22q11 deletion syndrome, early detection and diagnosis is essential for effective long-term management. Awareness of the patient's long-term baseline state and monitoring for changes in behavior, in emotions, in thinking, sleep, fatigue, and overall functioning is crucial. This will facilitate diagnosis and ongoing long-term management and provide goals for determining efficacy of management and treatment in the future. Attention to other 22q11 deletion syndrome associated conditions should include caution about endless searches for physical causes of treatable psychiatric illnesses. When it comes to non-pharmacological interventions, one should first of all look at potential environmental factors that may underlie the emergence or maintenance of psychotic symptoms. For example, have there been any traumatic experiences that have not been yet discussed? Has there been any cannabis consumption? We know that cannabis is a risk factor for psychosis. We also know that traumatic experience is a risk factor for psychosis. So this should be discussed and avoided. Has there been any recent cognitive assessment to rule out cognitive deterioration? We know that people with 22q11 deletion syndrome may undergo cognitive deterioration, particularly people with psychosis. So if this has been the case, then there should be an adjustment in daytime activities, for example. From all interventions for psychosis, for example, cognitive behavioral therapy or acceptance of commitment therapy, this has taken a solid place in the treatment of psychosis in the general population. However, this has not been studied yet in people with 22q11 deletion syndrome, but it might be useful to give this type of treatment when also taking into consideration the level of intellectual functioning. In addition, comorbid trauma can be treated with trauma therapy such as EMDR, eye movement desensitization reprocessing. And of course, when giving these therapies, the therapists need to be aware that people with 22q11 deletion syndrome often have intellectual impairments, so the adjustment to the protocol may be necessary. In conclusion, in general, psychosis in 22q11 deletion syndrome is treated in the same manner as non-deleted psychosis, although comorbid disorders common in 22q11 deletion syndrome may complicate treatment to some extent. Awareness and extra monitoring for side effect is recommended. Fear of and associated stigma related to standard treatment for psychiatric illnesses should not prevent the adult with 22q11 deletion syndrome from receiving effective recommended management for psychosis.